Hey traders, Raghee here, and in this free video I'm going to walk you through a few things that we did in the chat room this morning and give you a quick recap, because this is exactly what I'll be doing tomorrow morning when I do the open in the chat. So first thing, you can see about 8:55 a.m. we had the 1 day relative performance. Now this is a look at the FX markets, looking at the individual currencies and their relative performance to the dollar. So I just get a ranking. That's really all you need to be concerned about here. It's a ranking. So you'll notice that the yen, 25 minutes before the bell opened, was already weak. Now this is a pretty clear sign from the currency markets that we could see strength in stocks. So 35 minutes before the bell, I'm already thinking, wow, this market's already put in a low. It's looking somewhat bullish since 7 a.m., but the yen is definitely signaling that regardless of the kind of volatility we see on the open, it's pointing to stronger stocks, which makes me a little bit more hesitant to be too ambitiously bearish on the open. Well, we get the open, and the market does a few things. First of all, you'll notice that we're going to use our hourly price movement range here. Now, this is what's known as the HPMR. Some of you are already familiar with it. I taught a class on it well over a year ago, and this is a technique that I developed using auto chartist volatility analysis to project highs and lows. So this is a strategy that I developed, and now we have the automation of the tool that feeds from the auto chartist data. By the way, we make this free to members, okay? So we have this running, and you can see right before the open, right on the open, we dipped right into the HPMR low. Now, I'm not saying this creates this automatic buy. I don't want anyone thinking that the standalone HPMR is enough just to say buy here, sell here, buy here, sell here, although some of my traders do that, and that's just exhaustion fade buying and selling, which is fine. But if you think the markets are gonna sort of sell off because everyone thinks that's what's going to happen, and it lands right into an hourly historically validated support zone, that's pretty bullish. And as we progress through the morning, we can see that we end up with some fairly bullish propulsion dots, and also the pullback to the wave, pullback to the VWAPs. I mean, this was a morning that was indicating strength from the get-go. Bonds were not indicating this. Gold was not indicating this. Pre-market was not indicating this, but yen was. And then the behavior, as you can see, started to reflect what the yen had forewarned us of. And then the structure right from the bell said, oh, boom, right into the hourly price movement range, projected low, and then green grab candles, and we never looked back. So some of the aggressive 15-minute breach retreats, for those of you that are familiar with my work, you know were valid. And then just later on in the morning, and still during a pretty viable time, we had a pullback into our VWAP cluster, which is a little bit more of one of our more aggressive entries. And of course, we want to have the long trade trigger confirm that buy. Now I'll talk about the earlier 15-minute breach retreat setup. So for those of you that want the more aggro, check out the premium video. We'll jump into the details there. But I want to, you know, just kind of remind you guys, we're going to continue on to the new year with this same approach. Breach, breach retest, breach retreat. I'll see you in the next update.